We would now like to start regular press conference by Foreign Minister Motegi. Minister, please. Nothing for me at the moment. Please ask a question. If you have a question, please raise your hand when you are named. Please come to the standing microphone in front and please identify yourself and your affiliation before you ask a question. Yamamoto-san, please. NHK Yamamoto. Day after tomorrow, 7th of February, is the Northern Territories Day. The peace treaty negotiation between Russia and Japan and the joint economic activities. I have a basic question. For the past 1 year for the coronavirus infection, you have not able to have a face-to-face negotiation. The situation is very difficult. Therefore, the progress of negotiation and also the projects, how are they going? What is the prospect for the future?
So it is true that going back the past 1 year and 1 year before that, at the end of 2019 in Moscow, we had a negotiation because I'm the person who are in charge of a negotiation, both myself and Foreign Minister Lavrov had more than 8 hour negotiation. We have had a series of negotiations as such, and going forward, just as when a way ahead was looming, the outbreak of the virus happened throughout the world, and since then it's been very unfortunate that a face-to-face consultation has not been held. At last October, at the foreign minister's telephone meeting, we concluded to advance a negotiation on peace treaty and continue discussing. And between Prime Minister Suga and President Putin, the negotiation on peace treaty included between Japan and Russia. The exchanges are to be carried on. That is being confirmed. Well, frankly speaking, resolving a pending issue of our 70-year period since the war is no easy job. However, through negotiations thus far, where we can agree bilaterally and where we differ in our respective positions have become much more clearer. That's my feeling. So as a person in charge of a negotiation toward achieving the goal of by resolving territorial issue and concluding peace treaty is something that I will work all out for. And also as for the projects in four islands and also humanitarian measures and so forth, last year because of the coronavirus, not much has been done. It all depends on the situation of the coronavirus going ahead, but if it gets improved, then once again, it will be restarted. That's our intention. At any time, at any rate, between Japan and Russia, between authorities and people concerned, in preparation for the things to come, we will make a good preparation.
Next question, please. Fukuda-san. Yomiuri Fukuda, I have a question regarding Myanmar. Aung San Suu Kyi has been detained. Regarding the detention, the U.S. government is indicating the possibility of reimposing sanction. If the detention of Aung San Suu Kyi and others is prolonged, the Japanese government may consider imposing sanctions. What is your view?
Yeah, first of all, well, state of emergency has been declared in Myanmar, and events undermining democratization process is occurring in Myanmar, and Japan is gravely concerned. On the very day that the incident had occurred, MOFA minister comment has been issued. So far, Japan has been strongly supporting democratization process in Myanmar and supported its advancement. The movement to counter that type of trend is extremely unfortunate. Within the international community, Japan is a country who has a various communication route in Myanmar, including military. Just 2 days ago, we had a Japan-UK 2+2 meeting, and Japan has been asked for a view about the situation in Myanmar. So internationally, there is a recognition building. And yesterday at the noon break, Ambassador Maruyama in Myanmar, whom I contacted to inform, to be informed about what's happening in the Japanese businesses operating in Myanmar. So in Myanmar, we really hope that early on, democratized political regime will be restored as soon as possible, and we will seek Myanmar military to do so. So we will communicate duly and look at the situation to develop in Myanmar closely. And by keeping a close eye on the development locally, and we will cooperate with the relevant countries, and the G7 foreign ministers joint statement has also been issued. So based on this, we will think about the actions to take going forward.
Fukuda-san, once again. I have a follow-up question. The government and opposition parties, some people are calling for the establishment of Japanese version of Magnitsky Act.
Yes, first of all, Japan is a country who sees the human rights as a universal value, and protecting human rights is the basic responsibility of any country, every country. And based on that notion, vis-a-vis the grave violation of human rights, we will raise our voices. And based on the dialogue and cooperation with countries who are making efforts toward the democratization and the protection of human rights, we are willing to have bilateral dialogues and accumulate cooperation, and have asked these countries to voluntarily take action. Within that context, you mentioned about the situation where unilaterally recognition is made for the violation of human rights and sanction will be taken. With regard to that, whether that kind of system should be introduced into Japan or not, well, so far, Japan has been rolling out our human rights diplomacy, and we are also watching carefully the developments in the international community, and we will have an intensive analysis before making decision.
Next question, please, Mr. Azuhari.
Thank you, Mr. Panorama News. I would like to ask about terrorism in West Africa, Northwest Africa. It seems that terrorism is back there in that area with the attack in Tunisia yesterday that claimed the lives of four military soldiers. Japan suffered casualty actually in that region, including one time when in Algeria 8 years ago, and I think you were Minister of Meat at that time. There were 10 Japanese killed in a terrorist attack on Aminas. I would like to ask, what is Japan's steps to prevent such terror attacks in that region and to protect your interest in that area? Thank you.
Well, you talked about terrorism, which had occurred in Tunisia. The terrorism can never be justified or legitimized on any ground, and Japan will sternly condemn a terrorist act of every form. Japan is taking various measures on the counterterrorism in North Africa. We've done many measures before. As you had mentioned, in case of Tunisia, raising capacity for border control assistance has been given, and also Japan-Tunisia terrorism dialogue is being held, and views have been exchanged with Tunisian government, including security authorities. Last November, December, I myself visited Tunisia. I met President Saeed and Prime Minister Musisi, and we confirmed to work closely, including security areas as well. And going ahead, we will cooperate with the relevant countries concerned and work toward peace and stability of the region.
Any other questions? If not, yes, please. Sankei Ishinabe, I have a question regarding Myanmar situation. As you said earlier, within the international community, Japan has many routes of communication, including the military. Already, do you have a communication with the Myanmar military in order to convey the government's view?
I would say that this is a very sensitive issue. in various different forms. To what extent the exchanges have been held, that's your question, but at this time I would like to refrain from commenting on that.
Yes, please. Ishinabe Sankei, once again. Today, the US President, President Biden, gave a foreign policy speech. He showed a hardline approach to China and Russia. However, allies, including Japan and coalition partners, he wants to rebuild the alliance. What is your view?
All right. You talked about President Biden's speech on the US foreign policy. The key word is America is back. There are many international issues out there, but US has expressed its intention to exert leadership. And also in rolling out the diplomatic policy, it was said that it's important to cooperate with allies and had referred to holding of the telephone conversation with the leaders of the allies, inclusive of Japan. So Japan highly appreciates the position of Biden administration's policy along this line, as well as President Biden. Just the other day, I had a telephone conversation with State Secretary Blinken. We exchanged views on the regional issues, as well as FOIP, Free and Open Indo-Pacific, how important they are. And we concur to closely collaborate on various agenda items faced by international community, inclusive of coronavirus measures and the climate changes. And also, in terms of the connectivity and linkage amongst the democratic countries, we concur to revitalize G7 as well, going ahead between Prime Minister Suga and President Biden and I myself and State Secretary Blinken and many other levels. Japan and U.S. would work closely together so that Japan-U.S. alliance can further be strengthened and work on the free and open Indo-Pacific and cooperate in various areas having Japan and U.S. at the core. Thank you.
Any other questions? If not, I would like to conclude. Yes, please. NHK Yamamoto. WTO Director General election. On that issue, Korean Trade Minister Yoo Mun-hee, she said she is going to withdraw from the candidacy. Therefore, there is only one remaining candidate from Nigeria. What is your view?
Yeah, today Korean government said that a candidate from Korea will withdraw from the candidacy of the DG of WTO because of the pandemic and various different countries are on the way to the economic recovery and the WTO reform has to go on. From that perspective, in last September, Mr. Azevedo had resigned and the position of Director General has been left vacant. And we have always said that it should be filled in as soon as possible. We have called on relevant countries to do that. And last year, selection process had continued and from Nigeria, Ms. Okonjo-Iweala had gotten wider support from a large number of member countries. That has been confirmed. So Korean government decided to resign his her candidate. And based on the procedures set, unanimous fashion, we hope that promptly Ms. Okonjo will be elected so that she will be ready to tackle various different agenda right away.
Any other questions? This concludes the press conference. Thank you very much.